5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
What is up, everybody? TRV number 80. Yes! Bring your own popcorn. How many of y'all got popcorn out there? Hope you all do. Hope you are all well on this lovely Friday afternoon. How y'all doing, fellas?
Thank God it's an extended goddamn weekend.
No shit. I'm actually doing really good. I had a really good talk with my boss today, and they're bumping me up positions.
Nice.
That's fantastic. That's always a good thing.
It hopefully comes with more perks than just a title, though, right?
Well, I go through a temp agency right now. Until I'm for like 500 hours and then it will.
Oh, okay. That's good though. Hell yeah.
It's like 3 months and then 3.5 and then I'll be full time. Like on their payroll instead of the temp agencies.
Yeah, that's always a good thing. That means you know you're good.
I see my instigators are in the house. What's up, instigators?
You know, Zero. Why are they your instigators? Aren't they ours?
Well, they are.
Are you yeah. having a sharing problem tonight? Is that what your I problem know. Is?
Spring doesn't want to share.
I'll be a sneaky bitch. Go dog, Zero. First off. Do y'all hate clowns as much as I do?
Nope.
So that's why I say they're my instigators, because they started putting clowns in there. So.
Now, Barbie used to be... Want to
go to a drive-in movie?
No, oh, Jesus. Barbie used to be deathly, deathly afraid of clowns until my little brother cured her of that phobia real quick. So.
I hate clowns. I hate dolls. Them porcelain little dolls.
Oh, yeah. Hell. Like Annabelle?
Yeah.
All crazy. What's up, Georgia boy? I see you.
Yeah, Annabelle had it all right, but I think Tommyknockers had it better.
Yeah.
Those ones were creepy.
That's very true. To
some in chat. Y'all want to say hello to some people in chat?
I say we let you do that.
Yeah.
Because I can share.
Go ahead, Spring.
First and foremost, shout out to E&B. And shout out to Miss Jane over at Shot Thoughts. They are a sponsor of this channel. And each of individual one of us. I can't talk today. We have Mr. Paca. Mr. Paca. Jason Leprechaun Paca in the house. We have E&B in the house. What's up, Miss Heather? We have Stu. What's up, Stu? Glad to see you. We have the lovely Melissa Simmons. How you doing? We have Nick Thompson. Our favorite Nick. We have Subaru Nerd Vapes. What's up, Sub? How you doing?
How you doing?
We have Georgia Boy, TFV Reviews. What's up, Georgia Boy? How you doing? We have Matthew. What's up, Matthew? Matthew needs an instigator color, I see. What's up, Miss Barbie? The lovely Barbie. How are you? We have Mrs. Subaru, Amy Cartier. What's up? And we have Zero. Zero Cool, my favorite Gator fan. What's up, Zero? Let's see. We have Jimmy James. What's up, Jimmy James? How you doing?
Jimmy James!
We have... Let's see. Who else we got in here? We have Kevin. 808 Kevin. Aloha, Kevin. How are you? Glad to see you.
Looks like Nate Chapman. He just came in. What's up, Nate?
What's up, Nate? Glad to see you. So, yeah, if I missed anybody, my apologies. I did not do that on purpose. Welcome, welcome, welcome. We are glad that you are here. So, fellas,
oh, God.
What?
Oh, Barbie just put in Zero. Have you seen my doll I got from my grandma? I don't get, like, weirded out by that kind of stuff, like Annabelle, all that. She, oh God, dude, she has, I think it might be from Germany. I know their Bible, they have a Bible from Germany and has like a thing of wheat in it, I think, if I remember right, or a flour that's been from over there, all that stuff. I don't know, that thing is creepy as shit. Like, their family thinks it's funny to put it in the backseat of other family members' cars. So when you walk out to the car, you see that thing, and that thing is fucking creepy. Creepy as shit.
That'd be fun to watch.
No.
That's my kind of humor.
Hell no.
Yeah, no.
Nope.
What do you mean we're not happy to see you, Georgia? Spring said we were happy to see you.
Always.
Georgia boy!
Barbie, I love you, but I don't want to see your doll, okay?
No.
Nope. I don't like dolls. I don't like anything creepy like that. Like, I won't watch movies of, like, possessed dolls and shit. Or Exorcist or, nope, not watching that shit.
But no Chucky? That's, come like, on, my that's main hilarious. Feature.
Yeah, well, Chucky me and Amy's main movies that we watch are usually horror films. But we don't really watch, like, the doll stuff or anything like that. We watch, like, the true, like, actual gory horror.
Yeah.
See, like, Tash, she knows that if she wants to watch some kind of horror, gory, whatever movie, she's got to watch it with the bestie. Because I'm not watching it. I like the drama, chick flick, happy-go-lucky movies. What's up, Nemesis? How you doing? Glad to see you. So, and comedy, yes. I like comedy movies. I'm just comedy's not fun. Into the Children of the Corn, you know.
Oh, that was such a good movie.
Shit like that. Yeah. The
original.
Yeah.
I'll tell you what's good. If you like comedies and like everybody likes superhero type movies and stuff, you guys really need to get on Amazon and watch this show called The Boys. I've talked about it before, but it is like this train wreck of a show. Like one of the, and but there's gore in it as well. Like people tend to explode a lot and stuff like that. But to tell you what kind of dark humor it is, the very first scene, like my coworker was telling me about it and I was just like, what? And he goes, so you got to watch it. So I knew the scene was coming up. So I was just literally watching Barbie's face. And the whole time, first 5 minutes of the show, she's like, this is stupid. This is stupid. Well, what happens is a guy is talking to his girlfriend and they're like hand in hand, but she's kind of off the curb, kind of barely into the street. And all of a sudden you see him in this red explosion. And he's like going, and they pan down and her arms are still in his hands and they're just like stumps. A speedster blew right through her as they were talking, and the guy stops. He's like, and he's just like tripping and covered, and he's just like, I gotta go. It just like takes off. But that'll give you like a little bit of a taste of that show. It is the most twisted dark humor comedy superhero show you'll ever see. You gotta watch that. It's called The Boys.
So you laugh. That's what's funny, is you laugh.
Oh god, yeah, it's hysterical. It's hysterical.
I like movies based on true events. That's I like those type of things. I don't know. I'm weird. Probably weird. But anyway. Y'all wanna do a buffet?
Yeah.
Buffet. Alright. Well, I'm vaping on the nunchaku with the barrage and the it's heavy tip. That just left my brain.
Wow.
Heavy tip on top of that, a little matchy-matchy goodness in there. I got some cositos mango, and then I got the Cali Burn cocoa, as always, in there. I got some MTL cream cheese flaky pastry. And then I have the knee box with the custom, it's a wrap. And then I got the vape bean latte in there, as always. That's a phenomenal juice inside of there. And then I have the Jackaroo with the custom Jimmy James panel with the grieve curve sitting on top. And in there I have a little concoction. And that is a little bit of half and half of guava flaky pastry and Shaitot's Mind Forge. It's really good. What you putting in your mouth, Viking?
Let's see. So I've got my everyday vape is the Boxer with the Steam Crave Ragnar on there. And of course, Big Tank needs big juice. So we got, the light just killed that. I'm back onto the apricot honey liquid custard by E&B. And then I've got the Odin 100 with the ether on top of that, running it. Let's see if it'll show up. Running it in temp control. Yeah, temp control, people. It's a thing. And I've got Miss Jane's Black Mojo in there, and it's doing really good in some temperature control. I got some I used some ribbon and did some ribbon twisted stainless for that, so it's working out really well. And then last but not least, and a little early birthday present from one of you peoples, we have got, yeah, it's the Death Wish Bogan custom. It's not gonna do it. It was focusing earlier, but you got the undead cunt himself right there, which is the V4, and it's of course the Unholy V3. Yeah, Unholy V3 RDA that it comes with. And running some Dark Star scones in there. A little nice coddled cream, some raspberry, and some biscuit. It's going really well. What you got, Spring?
Nice. I have the Aegis Boost with the RBA section on it with that Chiquita tip, which I'm really, really loving. In that, I have my own little mixture. I have the Pod Squad Mind Forge along with Pod Squad Mont Blanc in that. Actually, really, really good. Then I have brought back my Caliburn because my Artery Pal pod finally went. So there we go. Caliburn with some Sabore del Encanto Fajito in there. And then I have my heavy hitter with my Coil Turd and RDDA for vaping with my heavy tip. And in that, I have my crack, my Prohibition Syntax. We all know. You guys actually know for sure.
Yeah.
Then I have this beauty, my Boxer, with my intake dual and another heavy tip. I am really, really loving this mod. Every afternoon when I come home, that's what I want. And in that, I have that fire, that Casitos Mango. Yes, that is my go-to. So, yeah, that's what I have tonight. I don't have a lot of devices, but I do have some in rotation. I cleaned up my stuff, and there you go.
So that's the sad thing, is how you say you go to work, and when you come home, you're looking forward to this. That's what I need to stop doing, is I take this to work with me, too. So this is literally with me, work or home, it doesn't matter. I don't have any of the books. Oh, go ahead.
My daughter turned 5 today.
Nice.
And I'll be 34 on Tuesday.
Shut up.
Shut up.
Flip those numbers around, bitch. Then talk to me.
Oh, fuck off.
Yeah. No, I actually don't have any of the Bogan Brews left, Mr. Parker. But second time ever. First time was late 2018. I did win one of the small, because I had to lower my patron level with Bogan, I don't know, 6-7 months ago. But I did actually win the little $10 bundle he did. So I will have some doublers of the whole line coming. So I'm getting ready for that Kurang Cola again. Damn, that's good stuff.
I like the Duck's Nuts. That's the one I like.
Duck's Nuts is good, and so is the... why do I want to... Ridgy Didge. Yeah, the Ridgy Didge, which is that oatmeal raisin cookie that... totally tastes like oatmeal and raisin cookie. It's insane.
I think you was talking about the Boxer. You taking it to work and everything.
Yeah.
Okay, I take my pods to work. We all know that. My Caliburn, you know, I take two of them to work. That way I've always got one. But when I come home, like after 3 days, the third night it's on like 30% after 3 afternoons or whatever. And I charge it up, and then I'm good to go. Like, I vaped on it yesterday and today, and I'm just now at 51%. Battery life is great for me, which that was the whole reason I wanted one of these, you know, for a long time, was to check how battery life would be for me. And it's working.
So. Yes, I did let him know, Matthew, I wanted doublers. That way you essentially get more. Yeah, see, and that's the thing. Even me, I'm usually at a minimum of 100 watts on the Ragnar. I still... depends on how busy I am at work. Sometimes I can get almost 2 days, and this is the little one. You got the bigger one. I can sometimes get 2 days out of it, but usually it's when I get home, it's like 20% or so. So.
Yeah, so I mean... I'm impressed. The buttons aren't as hard as I thought that they would be.
Yeah.
I'm impressed with it. Shout out to whoever sent it to me. Thank you so much. I appreciate you very much. I'm honored to have it. So.
And just in case, because I know that there are some frumpy people at times, because I get frumpy, we appreciate all of you, even if you don't send us cool toys. We appreciate you because you're here and you like spreading TRV love, like herpes. Just spread it.
I appreciate everybody. appreciate everybody.
Come on, and see, this is why sometimes I don't talk right there. Zero. You got the little one for a little guy. Oh, shut up, bitch.
Zero's on a roll.
Always.
What y'all doing this week? This weekend, should I say, since it's a long weekend?
Tomorrow, we're having a birthday party for my daughter. And then I'm going, me and Amy, leaving the kids with grandparents and going to go party ourselves for my birthday party.
There you go.
We have another friend that is turning the same age and has the same birthday as me.
Nice.
So.
See, and that's how I know he's definitely the young one of the group. He's going to go out and party for his birthday. For my birthdays, it's...
I don't get to buy myself shit, so...
Give me some food. I don't know, yeah, see, and that's the thing. I don't get to buy my shit stuff either, you know? It's just, like, give me some food and let me pass out for the day. That is the most amazing birthday ever, so...
See, me, I'm one of those type of people. I can't fall asleep during the day. Like, no doing it. I can't fall asleep at night in any ways either. It's the ADHD. It just keeps me going constantly. Like, they always say a body in motion stays in motion. And that's how my body is. It's constantly going.
Wait till you hit 40. You'll love them, Matt. Just saying.
Amy's only 33 and she loves naps.
Because I got the new. I got the white ENB shirt.
Yeah.
So shout out to Heather. Loved it. We'll be wearing it at the beach. Speaking of.
Lucky duck.
See, and that's the thing is, I do have trouble sleeping, especially sometimes after work and all that, because I have ADD too. But with the meds, that helps with that. But my deal is, it doesn't matter if it's 8 in the morning, 2 in the afternoon, 8 at night, 3 in the morning, doesn't matter. If you fill up my belly and I don't move, done.
Yep.
Done.
See, I have to exude a lot of energy in order to become really tired.
I do that every fucking night, dude. That's why.
Amy says Subaru cannot have a white
shirt. Wait, what?
Amy said you can't have a white shirt.
This is true. First day I would have it, it'd get a stain on it. Whether it be e-juice or something else.
Dude, that's why I have two hampers. I have my work clothes hamper and then my not work clothes hamper because... And they got usually at least 10 feet of distance between two because I think there's sometimes that shit will actually jump out onto my non-work clothes just because how bad they are. Like, all my jeans, they're blue jeans, right? Nah, they look black. So, even with the... massive amount of scrubbing, and I even got that, it's like fast orange, like industrial worker laundry detergent. No, I have black jeans that were blue.
Sounds like when I was roofing.
Oh man, they are clowning you. Yeah, they are clowning you.
I mean, what about what?
No, they're spamming chat with clown emojis right now. And Matthew has found a skunk one and he keeps popping up too.
Hey, you know what? I don't mind skunk. I have a skunk tattoo. There you go.
Is it Pepe Le Pew?
It is. I don't think it's Pepe Le Pew. It's the other one.
The girl one?
I'm not bringing my leg that high to show you.
I'm trying to think. That's the only.
That's the only skunk that I know of.
No. Yeah, other than
his little the girl he's always trying to go after.
Oh, Jess, I thought you.
Are you talking?
Me.
Are you Which? Talking about Flower from Bambi?
I think that's the one.
Yes. Yeah, that's right. Yeah, because if you remember right, he was never chasing another skunk. Pepe Le Pew never chased another skunk. It was always a black cat. That ended up getting like
true.
A white paint stripe.
That was true.
Yeah, right there, Zero. She's a cat.
I love 50 with you.
But yeah, I completely forgot about Flower from Bambi. Good call. I'm not a flower.
Oh, hang on. Let me cut the lighting down so you can see it. Maybe.
There you go, Jimmy. Fifi. Fifi the cat. There you go.
Y'all ain't gotta quit talking just because I'm looking at something.
We get distracted easily. We're waiting. I'm just watching chat because there's some things I'm like, what? What?
I thought what? Jess loved me. I can't believe she sent me that shit.
What'd she send you?
A damn picture of that damn doll.
That's Flower. Yeah. From Bambi.
That actually, the signature in it is my mother's signature from a birthday card.
Oh, sweet. And,
she actually had a skunk on her ankle. So I got that in memory of her. Actually, it's on my right calf. My right calf? Yeah.
Oh, that sucks, Heather. Can't find that ice cream? That sucks. Actually, that's a good question. I wonder, since she's got her headphones on, she won't be able to hear me. Hi. Did you find that ice cream for us? Oh, yeah, she's got her headphones on. She can probably hear me now.
No, I can hear you. I said I haven't looked yet.
Oh, she hasn't even looked yet. So, Heather, I might not even be able to get that ice cream yet.
It's on my shopping list. I added
what ice cream?
Damn it.
What's up, Juan? How you doing? Glad to see you.
What's up, Juan? Ben and Jerry's just released or is releasing the pumpkin pie or pumpkin cheesecake or whatever ice cream flavor.
I just had some pumpkin spice cake the other day.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, was it Georgia Boy? No, Nemesis said to remind y'all that the pumpkin spice latte stuff that y'all like is
insane
now.
Hell yeah.
It's Starbucks. Starbucks can suck my ass. I don't... If I'm going to go out...
I'd rather have my
K-Cups. Yeah. If I'm going to go out and get coffee, I'm just going to go to Dunkin'. I mean, iced coffees are like $2.50 for a big-ass cup instead of $10 for this venti, douchey cup of shit.
Y'all are spending too much money. If I go get coffee, I'll go to Walmart and get some K-Cups and get some for $6 and have like 12 cups of coffee.
But you can't do the iced coffee that way. So.
Yeah, you can. You can make iced coffee with a K-Cup.
You probably can. My question or my thing is I'm too lazy.
Yeah.
See right there, Dunkin', or Melissa, Dunkin'. Yeah, go to Dunkin'.
See, it's City Brew over here.
Donuts, so if they have old-fashioned donuts, it's a winner for me. I'm all about the dough. Just saying.
They have some amazing old-fashioned.
Big one over here is City Brew and Mountain. The big one over here is City Brew and Mountain Mud.
Mountain Mud. What's up, Nemesis?
I would rather have an old-fashioned donut than any other donut. And Tash is like, how can you eat that? And I'm like, well, it's crazy, but if you go without sweets or bread or anything, the old-fashioned donut, you can taste the sweetness in it.
Mm-hmm.
It's so good. So.
You don't even have to cut that stuff out to do that. If it's a good old-fashioned donut, because I don't cut any of that stuff out, and I could still take a Dunkin's, you still get that just very light hint sweetness to it.
I don't know. I'd rather go Krispy Kreme myself.
I don't get along well with Krispy Kreme just because the fact that it's they make theirs out of potato flour. And it throws the flavor off for me. I can't deal with that.
It makes the flavor better, honestly, in my opinion.
Have you ever tried, like, the Tasty... Is it Tasty?
Tasty Cake?
Yeah.
Tasty Cake.
The seasonal donuts? Like, if there's a spring donut or Oh, now that's some good. I just love donuts. If you want to make me happy, give me donuts. Okay.
Yeah, they did
I'm sorry.
No, you're fine. I was going to say they. Go.
Well, anyways, Franz makes this one donut that's round, has the hole taken out in the middle, but they actually put raspberry cream all the way around on the inside. Oh my God, those things are so good.
Oh, I like fritters too, one. I like anything donut-wise.
Cherry fritters are way better.
I literally have a t-shirt that has a donut on the back of it that we found in Gatlinburg. Right? And it says that you complete me. It's got the little donut hole. Yeah.
Damn it, Nemesis. You're not supposed to tell people that. I had something in my eye. Ew. Warm Krispy Kreme glazed donut. Now, Melissa, are you talking about donuts or are you talking about something else?
When the light's on at Krispy Kreme.
Red light.
When the light's on at Krispy Kreme. That's the warm Krispy Kreme glazed donut.
Also when you can go. It's also when you can go in and get yourself a free donut.
Yep.
See, we don't even have one around here.
That's ours lame.
30 minutes away.
Yeah. No, Juan. Okay, I will say, I mean, fritters are good, whether it's apple or cherry. But cherry, if I can find a cherry one, I'll snatch that before I will an apple. But if there's not a cherry, I'll definitely grab an apple one.
See, I'll have a bear claw before I ever have a fritter.
Oh, what's wrong with
it? No.
Oh, my other favorite is coffee cake. I love coffee cake.
What's up, Hobart?
Mad Viking puts the holes in the donuts. Yes, sir. Just the little mini ones, though, not a full-size donut. Oh, what I was going to say, though, Spring, those tasty cakes, there were two that I can remember off the top of my head that were amazing. They had one year that was like the pumpkin spice or whatever. It was really good. But then I can't remember if it was for like a 4th of July once or when it was for, but they had like an apple pie donut.
Yes.
That thing was quad.
The strawberry was pretty good, too.
I just don't do with strawberry that much.
Yeah, strawberry was pretty good. I just, like I said, I love donuts. I mean, we've been sitting here talking about donuts for the past 15 minutes, but I love them. I'd rather eat a donut than ice cream, just the way it is.
Yeah, I totally agree with you on that. Donuts?
Donuts.
I even like crullers, and most people hate those because, like, you're just paying for air. It's like, I don't care. They're fucking tasty.
Maple bar. Oh.
We don't have maple bars here in fucking Kansas. I don't know why. I don't know if they're illegal or what, but there's no maple bars.
That's probably my second favorite. Old fashioned, maple, and then I like the old fashioned, I mean, just a regular old jelly donut. Love those. And I actually like the apple cinnamon where the apple's on the inside of it. Those are really good. Those are probably my four favorite right there.
Well, and it depends on where you go and who makes them, but I've had such a variety of like fritters, like especially apple ones. Like some don't have any kind of apple. You can tell it's a flavoring. Then some actually looks like apple pie filling that's in them and stuff like that. There was one, and I want to say it was at Dillon's, which if you don't have Dillon's, it would be Kroger for some of the other people. And they had, it was there for a while, but it was an apple pie fritter, and it was just like a regular apple fritter, but it had more of the apple pie like filling in there, and they also kicked up the cinnamon in there. Oh my God, you swear that thing was a mini donut this quickly as I ate that son of a bitch. It was like this big, and I think I took like maybe 6 bites. It was done.
If you ever come here to visit, if it's still open, we have what we call a Dutch's donut, Dutch's bacon. And we've got a Dunkin' Donuts on the other side of town, but we don't have a Krispy Kreme right here. That's about 30 minutes away. But I'll take you to Dutch's. And I'm telling you, we'll go early in the morning because that's when they, the freshest donuts. And when I tell you they literally melt in your mouth, they're that good. Yeah. They hands down beat Krispy Kreme and Dunkin' Donuts, period.
See, Nate, this time of year, the local apple orchards make cider donuts. So great on a cool morning when they're still hot. On my way to work, we actually have a fruit farm, and they do a lot of apple trees and stuff like that. They always have a sign that says they have apple cider donuts, And as long as I've been in Kansas, I haven't ever stopped there to try it, but they sound amazing.
Did you see what Matt put? He said Mad Mike, it has to use a donut after a camping trip with Subaru.
And it's not from sheer size. It's just that he chaps my ass that much that I have to have a donut.
Oh, dear Lord.
That was too funny.
He doesn't get enough cream filling.
Yeah. Where's the cream filling?
Oh, my.
I forgot what I was going to say. I'm just vaping. I'll remember later.
Oh, Hoback said something. Hang on.
Yeah. He was in an accident a while ago. Like maybe up to 2 weeks ago. Yeah.
He said he found out the truck driver got fired over it.
Yeah.
I'm glad you're okay, Hoback. I hate to hear that.
Yeah, I remember he's been talking. He's still pretty damn sore, but yeah, he made it out, essentially.
Loading a long box and trailer went forward. He never put air brakes on the trailer and me. Oh, shit, Hoback.
Yeah, that's right. That's right, yeah.
Damn. You know... That's one thing right there. I mean, that's rough. We've had people not lock the trailer in, and a driver go onto the trailer, and that trailer pull off, and the forklift and the driver's at the back of the trailer. Yeah. Shit. You have to lock them bitches in.
Yeah.
Damn.
Yeah, see, he said it was Monday, so it was just this week. I don't know why I was thinking it was last week. Damn. But who has had a still warm Portuguese custard? Now, that's a brulee cream filling. I don't think anybody, but maybe you have, you snobby French bastard.
You know, I have it. I'm a country bum. I ain't had nothing like that.
Nope.
Damn, Hoback, I am glad you're okay, man.
That's gotta be crazy.
If you've ever drove a forklift, you know that's scary. I drove one for years, and that was...
Dude, it just scares me. Sometimes I go to pick up a friggin' load of material at work and underestimate the weight of it, and I'm like... And I start to raise the forks. I'm not even paying attention. And then it's all of a sudden it's, and I'm like, oh shit, gotta get the other one. So yeah, I can't imagine actually getting, you know, falling off a fucking truck lift, basically. Screw that.
Because, I mean, you know, they teach you, if you've ever drove a forklift, most places, I mean, you go through this video class and everything, you know, what to do to brace yourself if that should happen.
Yeah.
And you sit there and you watch that and you're like, oh Lord, I hope that never happens. But I mean, I can't imagine what he was thinking, you know, going, okay, what the hell do I do? You know, because your first reaction is going to be jump off the damn thing, which is the last thing you want to do.
You just want to hold on for dear life.
Right. You know, I mean, I've been scared. I'm not going to lie. I hit a guy on a forklift one time. It wasn't my fault. By no means, but I hit him with the back end of it, thank goodness, and it wasn't the forks. You know, in a factory, in a plant, you get little critters. You get raccoons, you get possums, you get snakes, whatever. And we had a habit of getting copperheads, little baby copperheads in our totes, right? So there was one and it was dead. They found it in a tote, killed it. Well, the supervisor had it, and the 6'7" guy, right, was deathly afraid of snakes. I mean,
sounds like Amy.
Like Sissy Puss, afraid of snakes, okay? And they had done told him to get rid of it, then told the supervisor to get rid of it. Well, luckily, my plant manager, the maintenance manager, everybody was standing there. And he had went up and asked a question about the snake. Well, the guy turned around with the snake. I'm coming from one side, going to the other side, backing up. And as soon as he turned around, the 6'7" guy jumped right out in front of me. And I'm beeping the horn going, move! Boop, there he went.
Oof.
Put a probably a 50 cent piece dent in a steel toe. Asked him the next day, I was like, dude, how you feeling? He said, I feel like I got a damn forklift. I said, you did. Knocked it. I mean, it was bad. It scared me to death. I was off the forklift for hours. Just knew, yeah, I was about to get fired. But luckily, the plant manager sat there and said, she did everything right. She did what she was supposed to do. He just jumped out in front of her. Thank goodness.
Yeah, he was saying that they have racks that's 8,000 pounds of glass. That what makes that annoying is, like, not really annoying, makes that even scarier is, like, you know, 8,000 pounds is a light load that we put on our forklifts because, you know, it's all, you know, sheets of metal. So 8,000, that's light for us, but it's metal. Like, I've accidentally, like, grazed the, you know, like, one of the support beams and a tink, you know, it's whatever. They're metal sheets. But glass? Oh, screw that noise.
We used to have to do 55-gallon barrels of insulation material, like actual spray foam insulation, like the liquids, yeah, and stuff. And those things are not light. You have to load six of them at a time, and they're double loaded on top, like one barrel is on top of another barrel on top of one pallet. So it's a pain in the ass to try to move those motherfuckers off. Holy shit.
One said, driving a semi is not just getting behind the wheel and running. It's being mindful of everything and everyone around you. As a commercial licensed driver, that's including warehouse personnel. Yes, bless y'all. That's all I got to say, because I know that I've cut a semi driver off, not meaning to, but I have, and I can't even imagine. Melissa says, Mad Viking, at what age did your obsession with the ass start? When I went through puberty and my poopy.
You're welcome. I don't think Super heard that. Did you hear when I started having ass issues? When I went through puberty and my pee-pee didn't grow. That's what
sounds about right.
Yeah, see? Right there.
Oh, you never know. You never know how he's going to answer, ever.
No, you do. It's the worst possible thing you can think of. That's probably it.
Oh, me.
At least it'll be close.
So, did you get my message, sir? Mad Viking?
My message?
My chat message in Zoom?
Huh? Oh, no.
Mm-hmm. But even Barbie slapped her head.
She always slaps her head.
That's good stuff.
Yeah, I just thought about that. That was a bad idea.
What was a bad idea?
Well, when I checked the chat, it also shows it on screen, the chat.
Oh, yeah, no. Mm-mm. Can't do that?
Yeah, I already did it, so it was up for at least 2 seconds. So, yeah, you might as well go ahead and announce it, so...
Well, I haven't seen it yet. Oh, well, anyway.
Delay.
Yeah, there's a delay.
Always delay.
Oh, you can't even read it, really.
Okay. But yeah, I would still go ahead and announce it anyway, though. It's a good idea.
Okay. So, September the 18th, unless these gentlemen want to do a live show, I will not be available, which is not this coming up next Friday, but the following Friday. So, if they want to do a show, then they can, but I won't be here.
She'll be at the beach.
The beach.
It might be a TRV without me. I don't know.
No, there will not. There will not be a TRV without Spring.
Nope. So.
Zero. I'm not going camping. No. I'm going to the beach with some family, and there you go. We're going for a. Yeah, we're just going to the beach.
You know, camping at the beach Spring might always be more comfortable.
Well, that's true, but I was just going to say Spring always denies going camping with us.
I don't go camping with you. That is y'all's thing. I love you, Nick.
Way to go, Nick. Way to make me and Subaru feel insignificant. Thanks,
well,
Nick.
Well, my thing is if we go camping on the beach, what about the sand? That's going to get all everywhere.
Will be able to get into my crack.
It's just like sandpaper, though. Ow.
It's better than the needle that you're working with, sir.
Yeah, you wish it was a needle.
Melissa knows.
Always dropping Thor's hammer.
No, that's it for me. I'm done. No.
What are you done?
You do not insult the God of Thunder's hammer like that. It is way bigger than that. Come on. Jeez. You probably can't even pronounce it. Come on, pronounce it. Let's do it.
I don't even remember what it's called.
Oh, you go fuck right off. That's how it's pronounced. Fuck right off.
Yes, Juan, yes. Bonfire at the beach under the stars. Sounds good, though. 100%. Anything at the beach is good. Plain and simple. I love the beach. That, like Melissa said, that is my happy place.
And So is chlamydia better at the beach than too, then? Since everything is?
No, never had chlamydia.
Oh.
So you'll have to ask somebody that's had that.
Hell?
See? That's what happens when you talk shit on the Lord of Thunder's hammer. See?
Did you hear that?
Yeah. It sounded like a thump or a thunderclap, didn't it? Didn't it? See, that's what you get.
Shit.
Is it Mjolnir?
Mjolnir.
Mjolnir?
Yeah. Yeah.
Awesome.
Well, you got a twang in there that it makes it sound almost incorrect, but it's passable.
What was his axe? I can't remember what his axe's name was.
Oh, God damn it.
Bonfires in general.
That's really what it was? It was a Stormbreaker?
Yes.
But what was the proper name for it? That's the question.
Stormbreaker. Sorry, Spring, go ahead. We keep cutting you.
You're fine. I have a big old pile of rubbish and tree limbs and all that good shit out here in my fire pit waiting for it to cool off so that I can have a bonfire. Just saying. Yep. That's how we do it.
Oh. Hercules was playing with his baseball. That's what it was.
Oh.
Jesus. Your nerd card is revoked, Subaru Nerd Vapes.
Wait a minute. What does talking about Norse theology have anything to do about being a nerd?
That's all Vikings' whole thing.
It's my religion, yeah. What are we trying to say, Zero? I know what I'm trying to say, Zero. Fuck your face. That's what I'm saying.
What's up with fucking faces tonight?
Again, it's like the ass. It's you know, it's
just another hole.
When you're not working with much, you can't have a lot of stuff in the way. Oh.
Jimmy James said the fuck right off sounds more Russian than anything.
You gotta be more angry and more like throaty for it to be Russian. So instead of just fuck right off, it's gotta be like a fuck right off.
Fuck you. Fuck you in the face.
That does not sound Russian.
What he was saying. And then it kicked in. That's good stuff.
Smirnoff.
You ever seen that? Right you on. Ever seen that? You ever seen that comedian? That he's the machine. He never wears a shirt while when he's up doing stand up comedy.
No, I've
watch
heard
it.
About him. But
it, no, watch it. Okay, you just have to watch the story about the machine. It's about him and the Russian mafia. It is so fucking hilarious.
Melissa. If I could fuck my own face, would I? Yes, but then also on top of it, I wouldn't be so worried about asses because you know what kind of porn star action you got to have going on of size to be able to fuck your own face? Just saying. I wouldn't be all about the asses because it doesn't matter. I could reach you from 3 feet away. Jeez. Come on. Use your brain.
We're not Ron Jeremy here.
Yeah, I'm actually skinnier than Ron Jeremy.
Here we go.
Probably taller too.
Yeah, I don't look like Mario. It's a me, a Mario. Taking in the pooper. Ting, ting, ting. Oh, high score.
I'm the mushroom.
I'm just telling you, the whole deal, the whole Mario series was based on a porn anyway. He's always chasing after that one chick.
He's always getting Viagra by a big reptile too. Looking.
What's that?
He's always taken Viagra as well.
Yeah, he keeps growing and growing. Stomping on mushrooms. Yeah.
Oh, eating mushrooms.
He doesn't eat mushrooms in the game, you dink.
Well, how else is he supposed to consume a mushroom to be able to get big?
I was thinking Goomba's mushrooms. I forgot about the other ones. My bad.
Come on, man.
You have to be on mushrooms that you think if you grab like a feather, you get a hat and a tail and you can fly after that. So you got to be on mushrooms.
And then when he's got his fire, when he's got his little fire power, that's when he's got herpes.
It is a flower and a vagina is like a flower. So there you go. We are completely fucking up Mario tonight.
My dog is trying to get in my room. Do you hear that? Heathen.
She
can't stand it.
What?
They can't stand it. When I've got the door shut.
No, you said heathen. I'm
like,
what?
Oh, my God. My heathen. What out there?
Spring looks weirded out. Yeah, when we get on a rant, that usually is what happens, Parker. I mean, shit,
Spring just sits back and lets it happen.
You know,
dude,
there's no controlling these two anymore. Why isn't
it? Is that just us two?
It is.
It's not just us two. You have that look usually on most after Zooms too, because usually I'm poking along with somebody else, and you're just sitting there going, "Oh God, here we go." Dicks, ass, vagina. Creamsicles. Oh, God. Here we go.
Booby tassels.
Hey, at least a woman always knows when to go. She knows when to leave the room. Gotta go. Bye. Y'all have a good day. I'm out. And yes, Melissa, they do. They do. She says your babies always want to be by your side 24/7. Girl, when I get home, it's crazy. So you actually had control at one point, Spring. No, I'm not going to say that.
Well, no.
They let me think I did, but no.
That's what I say. There's times that you do, like when I'm just not feeling very jovial and people start talking. I start yelling at people and let you talk all the time. So it happens.
Unless it was last Friday, then it was 2:30 a.m. 100%, Matthew, we did, didn't we?
Jesus, you guys were up till 2:30?
Yeah, we were in Zoom till 2:30.
Yeah.
We would talk about something, and then we'd jump to something else, and we were talking about retro vapes, which is, get me started on that, you know, because I know some of the ones that I had used back in the day. I wish I still had some of them. But you're always yelling at people? Who's yelling at people? I ain't never yelling at nobody.
No, I think he's saying I am. What is going on here? What the shit? I'm just looking at OBS. It's starting to drop frames, which is weird. We're like streaming at 6,000 kilobytes a second. How are we dropping? Like, we're using 2% of the CPU. So it's got to be... it's got to be Facebook. Or Facebook. It's got to be YouTube.
She is here.
Weird.
Say hi. Say hi. Don't be shy. No. Yeah.
Look at the camera. There you go. Look at the camera. No, not her face. Look at the camera.
She wants to put her paw in my face. She has that problem.
Oh, yeah. This
is my juju.
Oh. This is the baby of the crew.
That's the baby of the crew. This is one of the... She's half Pitt, half Jack Russell.
Oh. Melissa said... Well, it's not Zoom, Melissa. It's actually the actual encoder software / the connection to YouTube. It's gotta be. That's so weird. Huh. It's not storming outside, is it? I wait for the lag and for Barbie to respond. I don't think it is. Anyway. Yeah, anyway. Matthew, why does everything... I shouldn't even ask this question, but why does everything have to involve drinking with you? I mean, I'm just saying. No drinking, Friday poker, then what? No.
That's his thing. Your thing is asses. His thing is beer.
Well, yeah, but the thing is I'm not going to hang out in Zoom while he drinks. And he's all like, let's play poker and drink. I'll be like, okay, fine. Where's my ass? And I'll play poker. I mean, come on.
I was just going to ask, who are we poking?
Jimmy James was in that late night Zoom with us last week, too.
Because so Jimmy James shows up late.
Yep, it was me, Jimmy James, Matthew. It was pretty cool.
Oopsies.
Getting down there. Okay. She just wanted to say hi. So there you go. Yeah. Now she's going to go and lay on the pool.
Huh?
She's the rotten one. She's the one that I, she's apparently TikTok famous. I will tell you that. Everybody loves any video that I do in TikTok that she's involved in. Like, everybody likes it. I get a lot of views on it. So. She's my TikTok famous puppy. She's the one that has decided to steal my pillow. And so, yeah. She's the baby of the crew. Rotten. Just saying.
Oh, bastards. Barbara just posted, no pumpkin cheesecake ice cream at our store. Son of a bitch.
Heather said she went. She done been to three. And couldn't find it.
You see, it must
probably
be something
not
that
out yet.
Yeah, it's probably just not out yet. Some bitches. I hate when they do that.
Tease you.
Yeah.
And get everybody riled up over it.
Don't tease a fat kid. That'd get you hurt.
Barbie, I don't know if I send it to me. I've seen different ones.
She was telling me about that the other day. He like yells at his llama or whatever. Or alpaca, or whatever he has.
I love TikTok. I told Tash we was going to have to do some TikToks this weekend. Love TikTok.
You shut your whore mouth, Matthew.
Heather said heathens. There's also an ice cream shortage. Stock up. Make your own. Homemade ice cream.
Oh, yeah.
There you go.
I eat ice cream during the winter, so I'm good.
Yeah, that's when I like ice cream the best.
I like my hot coffee during the summer and my ice cream during the winter.
I've never really drank hot coffee in the summer until I got on the keto coffee, and now I do. I drink it every morning while I'm at work. So. Tash got, she found this coffee pot that she wanted, coffee maker. I call it the high-end coffee maker because it looks like something from the future. The price wasn't high-end, But it has just a regular coffee pot for when Pop comes over on Sundays, and then it has a single cup just for her during the week. That way she doesn't have to make a whole pot and waste it. So. Oh, okay. Jess, I love you, but I'm deleting your last message. Not the TikTok one, but the other one.
I can't. Everything... Amy says everything's getting bad. We already have nothing on our shelves in our grocery stores. We were like that months ago, but they've recovered a while ago.
Well, you got to understand here. You got to understand here in the valley, we have Glacier National Park, we have Big Mountain, we have lakes all around, and it's like one of the biggest tourist spots here in Montana. And when the tourist season comes in, everything is pretty much gone.
Yeah, no, it took them a while, but I mean, all of our stores, when the pandemic hit hardcore over here, it was hard to fucking get anything.
I just now, no lie, you know, everybody was going through getting all the toilet paper, right?
Yeah.
We go to Sam's and get toilet paper. Well, the first time we went, all they had was the industrial size rolls that you get from like a plant. You know, I mean, they won't even fit on your toilet paper roll, okay? That's how big they are. We are finally, now this was back, okay, probably, let's see, it's September, it's probably April when we bought that box, right? And we are finally, we're still not done with the industrial rolls, like so much that my sister comes in and says, did you steal toilet paper from work? No. This is stuff I bought from Sam's. But I had ordered our normal from Sam's probably about a month ago, and it's sitting in the room. I'm just trying to get through this other stuff before we get back to the good stuff.
Dude, I tell you, Zero, you're going to get hurt. Keep teasing Barbie with white cheddar popcorn.
Hey. I'm
telling you, man. I mean, the stuff is crack. I will have to say it's crack, but she will never fight anybody for anything. But for, I don't know, a bag of that popcorn, she might throw a couple punches for that.
It's good stuff.
It is. It's crack.
So what do y'all got coming up this week? What kind of reviews or something? Or this weekend?
I got some juice reviews, but. That'll probably be on Sunday. I got to get some juice reviews out. Last review I did was on an RDA. It was an RDA review, so I got to get some juice now.
I got thanks to Heather, I got the line of the new Casitos, so I got to definitely get those. But, I mean, I have some things that are shot that I need to get edited and uploaded, like the Aries 2, the Manto AIO. This weekend, I definitely will finally, hopefully, since I got an extra day, get the Rye finally shot and built. I haven't touched it yet, so that's definitely something. And, you know, in case anybody asks, I actually tossed this up when I got it all the way up into like an hour before we started the show. I'm not going to do a review on the Deathwish Bogan. Main reason why is because they only ran, I think it was, what did I say it was? 500? No. Yeah. Something like that. It's a very limited run, and they divided it between the three finishes. If you go to, like, Vapors Cloud US, they only have a couple stainless left. If you go to Evolution Vaping in UK, they got a couple of each left, but I'm pretty sure Deathwish is completely out, so kind of really don't want to do a review on something and then have somebody like, dude, I need to get one of those, and be like, sorry. So that's the only thing that I know I have planned. Yeah, 180 of each. Thank you, Zero.
Nice.
Now it was lower than 800. It was like I thought it was like 550 or something like that. But I'm pretty sure Zero's right. It's 180 of each color, and they had stainless, they had black, and a gunmetal, and then that was it.
Cool.
Shit. What is that supposed to mean, Matthew? You're trying to say all I review is old stuff? I mean, hey, can't keep up with, you know, beer swilling, high-end V&D, whatever, using tank mofo like you.
I'm actually trying something different. So bear with me. Instead of my normal editing software, I'm playing around with Filmora, actually, at the moment, trying to figure it out and, you know, see what else I can do. Trying to up my game. Let's put it that way. To make things a little bit better. So that's what I've been doing. I haven't really been buying a lot. As you know, I've been working more on my room and the view, you know, the computer and stuff like that. But I've got the Pulse V2 Squonk coming, actually. Ooh. I'm pretty interested in it.
Oh.
Because, you know, I like the top side, so I wonder how the bottom side is. So we're going to try it out. And it'll probably be here next week. Due to the holiday, you know, so I'm excited about that. But other than that, I'm still reviewing some of the stuff I've got here. Like right now I'm editing the Poker 218 by Tesla, so we'll see how it goes.
Okay, Matthew's officially a douche now. That's what the retro wave was. He's saying it just takes me 6 months to get a review out. I'm telling you, man, last six weeks, something like that, work's just fucking killing me, dude.
Well, and then with your machine getting broken.
No, that was literally last night. Well, they did it yesterday. So, of course, what I had to do was I had to be in D-Burr all night, which is in the corner of the shop with no airflow whatsoever, and all you're doing all night long is breaking parts out of the heavier lasers, where the parts are 200-300 pounds a piece. You stack them after you take them out of the shell, then you put the shell away, and then you have to grind the tabs off each one of those damn parts and put them on their corresponding pallet. So yeah, no, it's dope. Deeper sucks. It's like the seventh layer of hell in that entire facility. Like, if you get stuck in Deeper, you either did something wrong or you had no clue it was that much of a pain in the ass, and you were like, I'll go do it. And no.
Amy said your dog is facing Subaru. He needs his cuddles, anxiety-ridden 180-pound lap dog.
Yep.
Melissa, it's got to be hard working full-time and having a channel. It's challenging. Definitely. It's definitely challenging now. And I think that if you want to do something on YouTube or Instagram, go for it, girl.
Oh, yeah.
Go for it. I'll follow you just to see what you're going to do. So, yeah, more power to you. Do it. Do it to it. That's just, yeah. Anybody wants to get on YouTube and, you know, put out some content there. You never know until you know, the Late Night Beat Show. What's up? How are you? Glad you were here. Welcome.
Good morning. Yeah,
you know.
Trying to figure out. So, late night. Unless it's real early in the morning, late night is either from Australia or maybe China. Because it's 9:30 a.m. in China and 11 in Adelaide. So.
Nice. Glad you're here.
And that tells you how much of a fan I am of Bogan. I have his time zone in my phone.
Zero says I'm going to do a 3-minute warning review channel. Everything you need to know in 3 minutes or less. Do it, Zero. I want to see it. Do it. I think
he's fantastic. From the UK, so. Wow. It's like 2:30 in the morning there, dude. A real early good morning for you, sir. Or ma'am.
Miss Heather says, I'm proud of y'all. Y'all work your butts off and still are here every freaking Friday. Well, yeah, we love it.
Except for spring is going to the beach.
Hey, twice a year I go to the beach. I miss the show.
I go zero times a year. You think you're better than me, beach bum? Oh, okay.
No, I don't think I'm by no means. I'm sure that you will see some things. You know, you'll see pictures and different things.
Oh, yeah, that's such the same thing. Just watching everybody have fun at the beach while you're not. Yeah, thanks. That's such a gift from you. You and Jane can suck it. Because even Jane's all like, look at the food I got today. Look at this view and shut up. Just kidding. We like the pictures. We just secretly hate you for 10 seconds. Yeah, but that's like a California LA beach thing. I heard those aren't like those are like the Motel 8 of beaches. I'm just saying. So, Heather, you can't impress me with your beaches.
I like the beaches over in Washington and Oregon.
Those aren't beaches.
There they are.
All day long. Panhandle.
I said those aren't beaches. Those are winter waterscapes. That's all over there.
It's still a beach.
Sure. The bad thing, Zero, she probably did. As soon as you tagged, if you tagged Jane in anything, she probably gets it immediately. So.
We are past the hour mark, fellas.
Yes, ma'am.
So what you got to say, Subaru?
I'm Subaru Nerdbates. You can find me right here on YouTube. You can find me on my own channel, or you can find me here every Friday at 7:30 p.m. Central on the TRP Crew Show. You can also find me here with a beautiful Mad Viking and a Spring Awing. I'd also like to give a big shout out to all y'all out there in YouTube land. If you try to get off the Mickey sticks, keep on to the vaping. We know that there's government brand officials out there that are trying to keep us from vaping. But, you know, we all know that vaping is better than cigarettes, and it's a better way to get off the cigarettes. But anyways, all y'all out there in YouTube land, this is a public service announcement. Be good to your neighbor. And have a good day. This is Subaru Nerd Babes. We're out.
What you got, Mad Bucket?
San Pedro in Texas. Oh, okay. Yes, so of course you can find me on YouTube, Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, all those good social media places, and of course here with TRV. excuse me. But speaking of Twitter, definitely go to Twitter. If you've not been there, you need to go there for almost up to the minute updates on vape advocacy. Definitely go there and support what I'm coining as our vape generals of advocacy. And that's going to be, of course, Nick Grim Green, Matt from Suck My Mod or SMM, Phil and Dimitri. Of course, you know those guys. And even Vaping Bogan. They're always on there, constantly retweeting, making great political connections to help us fight the fight. Definitely go support those guys because they are definitely doing a thankless job, and you know it's really hard to get support from them sometimes. We will do spurts, but we just need to keep supporting them, so because they're going to be the ones that help us help turn around hopefully one day. But I want to give a special shout out to Darkstar, Mr. Mikey MF and Green at Darkstar, and of course Jane at Shy Tots, and Heather at ENB, and I want to give a personal shout out to Steam Crave. Thank you for signing me up for your reviewer list. Sorry, got distracted. Anyways, but that is all I got today, so I blanked out what I was even thinking about. Damn it, I need more medication. Just want to thank each and every one of you yet again for coming to Vape with a Viking, a Subaru, and a Spring, and we'll catch you later. Spring!
So, yeah, shout out to ENB, shout out to Shot Tots. If you have not checked them out, I don't know what you're doing with your life. You need to head on over there. Got them codes, TRV15, Spring15, MadViking15, and Subaru15. Any code you want to see. Don't forget, tomorrow is the rally. If you are going, thank you. I wish that I could go. I'm sure all of us on the panel wish that we could go. Remember, we vape, we vote. Do your part. You know, that's all there is to it. They're trying to take it away from us. We don't need them to take it away from us. If you're like me, vaping saved your life. Plain and simple. So, huge shout out to the ones that are able to make it. And remember, do your part. Do what you can do physically, you know, whatever. Because we want to keep vaping around. It's very important. So, on that note, thank each and every one of you for coming out and hanging out with TRV tonight. And remember, be nice, be kind, smile, and change someone's day. Hashtag don't be a Viking. Bye.